We know that the Ryzen 5600G is a very competent APU. It can run tons of games respectably using DDR4 3200 without any overclocks. But today, we have a look at how it performs when you pair it with blazing fast RAM and a daring Vega overclock. I got my RAM all the way up to 2366MHz. That's 4733 megatransfers per second. Remember, the DDR5 base speed is 4800. We are in striking distance of DDR5 here. Over 100% faster than the DDR4 base spec and 50% faster than the AMD validated speed of DDR4 3200. I've overclocked the Vega 7 GPU to 2500MHz, around a 33% increase. You can see all the details on the screen here, but please, if you have a 5600G, don't just take those numbers and plug them into your system. Your PC almost certainly will not boot up if you do that. I will soon make a video about tuning your system to get more out of your AMD 5000G APU. Stay tuned for that. But now, we'll have a look at how this setup performs. First up is Cyberpunk 2077. Cyberpunk is, to date, the only game that runs on Red Engine 4. The settings are the low preset with 16x texture filtering and high textures, and the resolution scale is 80% of 1080p. On the streets in the busy city, I get about 30fps, but in less active areas like the highways, it improves by about 5fps. The same is true for indoor areas like the street kit bar. I hope that the next gen update for Cyberpunk 2077, that's likely patch 1.5 on PC, will bring Fidelity FX Super Resolution, FSR, as an upscaling option. I'm optimistic about that, because if they want to have ray tracing on the PS5 and Xbox Series, they kind of need FSR to push adequate FPS. I will make an updated video on Cyberpunk as soon as that patch drops. Moving on to Control, which runs on the Northlight engine. As you can see, I'm rocking pretty high settings, and the render resolution is 768p. Why not 900p? It doesn't have 900p as an option, not even if you have a native 900p monitor. But oh boy, it runs well. Crazy. 50fps in this combat encounter that's got a lot of stuff going on. Control also runs much smoother than Cyberpunk. The frame pacing is excellent, with barely any hiccups. Outside of combat, I saw it hit 66fps, and it boggles my mind that this is possible in integrated graphics. I look forward to the RDNA 2 APUs that run on DDR5. Still, those won't be interesting for budget gaming until DDR5 prices are reasonable. Next up is Wolfenstein Youngblood. I'm running the low preset with high textures and maximum texture filtering at native 1080p. Youngblood is using the id Tech 6 engine, and id Software, of course, are the guys that make Doom. During combat, the frame rate varies slightly, but it is in the 45-55fps range. Again, the frame pacing is excellent, and there's almost no stuttering, which makes it feel smooth. You can see that the CPU usage goes up significantly sometimes. Over 50%, that's another great benefit of the Ryzen 5600G over earlier APUs like the 3400G. It's got a way more powerful CPU. The 6th Sense 3 cores are so powerful, there's no reason to overclock them, and I didn't. Let's stay with some id Software technology for a bit. It's Doom Eternal, which runs on the id Tech 7 engine, so the next iteration over the engine used in Wolfenstein Youngblood. My settings here are straightforward, all low except for the texture stuff, and then I'm using dynamic resolution scaling at 1080p with a 60fps target. I've tested a lot of games, and what I've learned is that dynamic resolution scalers are not all the same. Dynamic resolution scaling works exceptionally well in Doom Eternal. It hits a target without creating any weird stuttering, and the resolution changes. Sometimes you see dynamic scalers consistently overshoot and undershoot the target. Here, you only see it drop below 60fps if you already are at 50% resolution scale, because at that point, it won't go lower. And keep in mind, this is a busy fight, so the average render resolution will be lower here than otherwise. Next up, it's Metro Exodus, a game on the 4A engine. Here I picked the settings to make it look as impressive as possible, so it's native 1080p on medium settings. This is the Caspian map, or chapter. It's the one with the greatest draw distance, so this should be as hard as it can get. The 5600G mostly manages a frame rate in the mid-30s here. 30fps is okay-ish for this game, even though you might think it's a shooter. It's not really a shooter. Sure, you can shoot stuff, but if you play on the highest difficulty levels, you want to avoid combat whenever possible and take a much more stealthy approach. Archeom is very fragile and you don't have the ammo to spare anyway. The next game I only just played through a week ago, Hellblade: Senua's Sacrifice. an Unreal Engine 4 game. It looks beautiful anyway, but I'm running the high preset with textures on very high. I'm using FidelityFX Super Resolution on the ultra quality setting. So this is rendering at slightly below 900p. It runs well at 30fps or over. However, we get the occasional frame drop, as you can see in the frame time graph. But it's well playable on these settings. It's a great game, they'll do a regular video on it. I played through all of it with DDR4, 3200 and no overclock on the Vega GPU because I couldn't be bothered to restart the system. I was so hooked. Shadow of the Tomb Raider runs on a modified version of the Foundation engine, which powered Rise of the Tomb Raider. My settings are the medium preset with some texture tweaks, and I disabled anti-aliasing for the performance boost. The frame rate is in the 30 to 40 range, depending on the area we are exploring. That's good enough. Shadow of the Tomb Raider has a lot less combat than the previous two installments in the series, so I can't imagine I'd have a problem completing the game like this. For a 2018 game, it still looks rather impressive. They've even added ray tracing and DLSS, but they didn't add FSR. Alright, let's close with Assassin's Creed Odyssey, an Anvil Engine game. My settings here are entirely custom. It's mostly medium and high settings at 1080p, with anti-aliasing on low. Anti-aliasing on low or medium will make the game render at the sub-native resolution, improving performance. So I chose that instead of resolution scaling. The frame rate is neat, mainly in the mid-30s here. I think that's alright, because the timings for parry and dodge are rather generous anyway. I didn't test 720p, but I'm pretty sure it would hit 60fps. Alright, I will have an overclocking and tuning video soon. Please be patient, guys. Also, let me know what you'd like to see. I've gotten many great suggestions in the past. I'll see you in the next one.